Here we're talking about how to find the Fourier coefficients for symmetric waveforms. Let's start with an even waveform. So an even waveform, an example is shown here using a square wave. And if you look at this waveform, you see there's a type of symmetry. And the specific symmetry is that it's symmetric over the y-axis. So if you took everything on the positive part of the time domain and you folded it over the y-axis, the function would be exactly the same. So the mathematical definition for that is f of t is equal to f of negative t. When we write out the Fourier coefficients for an even waveform, we're going to get some simplifications. An is based on cosine, and actually that's going to be exactly the same. So let's just rewrite our definition, 2t integral from 0 to t, our function times cosine of n omega t dt. Bn is based on the sine function, but because this is completely symmetric, we actually don't have any sine components that will come out in the Fourier expansion. This means that the Bn will actually be zero. Since Bn is zero, Cn will just be exactly identical to A of n, An. Next, we'll talk about an odd waveform. And I've drawn an example here. And this is a different type of square wave, but it's shifted a little bit. And you can see that it goes directly through the origin here. The reason it's odd is because it's symmetric over the origin. Mathematically, this can be written as f of t is equal to negative f of negative t. And you can think about it as taking this side, flipping it downward, and then flipping it over the y-axis, and everything should match up. Or you can think about it as the function starts from the origin, and then both go in opposite but equal directions as time continues, and so that defines the odd waveform. When we're finding the Fourier coefficients, we are also going to see some simplifications. An is based on the cosine, and if you look at this odd waveform, it kind of follows the shape of a sine wave. So it turns out all of the an terms are exactly zero, which is very nice. For bn terms, those are based on sine, and those are actually going to be the same as the basic definition. So we'll rewrite the definition here. And remember, it's based on f of t times the sine of n omega t dt, integrated. Because our an is zero, cn, based on our definition here, is going to be equal to just bn. In summary, if you have an even waveform, you want to find the Fourier coefficients. We know that bn is zero, so you can solve for just an, and that term will be exactly the same as cn. For odd waveforms, we have essentially the opposite. An is always equal to zero, while bn has to be calculated. And then again, cn is directly equal to bn, which you calculated here. So this should simplify some of your calculations for finding the Fourier coefficients for your waveforms.